Hey everyone, welcome back. In this video, we're gonna have a look at the testing procedure on this ignition coil with three wires, which is used on this Suzuki Alto. So the testing procedure normally is very similar to other cars with ignition coil with three wires. So I'm gonna explain what are the differences between this type of ignition coils and the other ones that normally come with two wires. So we're gonna have a look at the wiring diagram. I'm gonna show you how to test the wiring, and later on, we will have a look at the oscilloscope as well to see how we can use the oscilloscope to diagnose this one. Before starting the video, if you guys haven't subscribed the channel yet, please don't forget to subscribe. We have many other diagnostic videos that you can find on the channel. First of all, let's have a look at the wiring diagram for this one to see what are the differences. We have some other videos on the channel for testing procedure on ignition coils with two wires. On those ignition coils with two wires, if you remember, we have one wire for the power supply and the second wire is the control line, which is going to provide the ground on primary circuit when ECM provides the ground, when it's time for the spark for that specific cylinder. So it means on those ones, we have two wires. One is the power supply and the other one is the control line. But here, as you see, there are some differences. First of all, we have the power supply over here on pin number 3, which is provided on both primary and secondary coils. Pin number 2 is the permanent ground. So normally on those ignition coils with two wires, we don't have permanent ground. Ground is actually the control line, which is provided by ECM. But here we have a permanent ground. And the last wire here is the trigger for activating the ignition coil. And as you see here, we have something extra inside the ignition coil, which is actually a transistor. When we have the coil unplugged with two wires, this transistor is located inside the ECM. So when you have ignition coil with three wires, this transistor is located inside the ignition coil. So that's why when we are talking about the trigger, it means ECM is not providing the ground directly on the primary circuit. ECM is just activating this transistor. So when this transistor is activated, we will have this ground provided on the primary circuit. So that's why the testing procedure on this ignition coil is a little different from what we had on ignition coils with two wires, because in this case, we can check the positive, we can check the negative over here. And for here, we can check it with the oscilloscope. Of course, we can check this wire with the multimeter as well for open circuit, for short circuit between the ignition coil and ECM. But the best testing procedure is to check the trigger signal with oscilloscope. Still, we have some testing procedure before proceeding to check the wiring. For example, if you have misfire for cylinder number 1, the quick testing procedure is going to be swapping this ignition coil with another one, like for example ignition coil number 3. If you swap these two ignition coils, if you see that the code is already moved to cylinder number 3, it means the ignition coil was faulty and you don't need to proceed for any other inspection. You already found the problem. If code remains on cylinder number 1 after swapping the ignition coils, it means the problem could be on the wiring on ignition coil or some other issues like the fuel or compression for misfire. Normally, if you look at the workshop manuals for those ignition coils with three or four wires, they don't normally recommend to check the internal resistance of the ignition coil. If you check, you will get some value, but normally, most of the time, there is nothing in the workshop manual to compare your reading with. We can check the spark tester as well to remove this one, to put the spark tester to make sure if this one is providing quality spark or not. But for the wiring itself, as I explained, we have three wires here. If I disconnect this one, between these three wires, this one, this black with yellow strips, this one is the positive, the middle one is the negative, and the last one is the trigger. If you check the other connectors right now in this car, you see the first and second wires are exactly the same color, but the last one, this one, comes with different color. Because this one is trigger, trigger has separate wires, but for this one, we can share the positive and negative. So right now that the ignition switch is on, if I check the positive over here between this wire and body ground, I should get battery voltage. So this battery voltage is provided on here. If you check the other ones, you have the battery voltage exactly on this wire. So this confirms that the positive is provided on all of them. Generally, all these positive come from the same source. So it means if that fuse is broken, you will have no power on all ignition coils and you cannot start the engine anymore. But if you have positive on a couple of them, but one of them doesn't provide the positive, it could be just one piece of the wiring or the connector problem. We can check the ground on the second wire as well, but the last one, which is the trigger signal, can be inspected by oscilloscope. So the best way for checking that is oscilloscope, because we can read the waveform. And the reason that I'm showing you this one, because we want to make sure if the ECM is triggering the ignition coil, and we want to see what are the differences between the waveform on this ignition coil with three wires and the other ones with two wires. Let's connect this one back. I'm going to set up the oscilloscope and then we will read the waveform. All right, for reading the waveform, as you see, engine is running right now and I have back prop here, this trigger wire on the ignition coil on the oscilloscope, and here is the oscilloscope itself. So as you see, I'm getting the signal right now. The maximum voltage is 5 volts, and this is actually the trigger signal that ECM is giving us. So the waveform that we are getting on this type of ignition coils with three wires is way different from the two wires one, because on the two wires we can get many more information because ECM is controlling the primary circuit directly. So we can read the dual time, we can read the peak voltage and spark duration. But in here, we can just read the signal that ECM is sending to activate the ignition module inside the ignition coil. So as you see right here, what we see, this is actually just a signal sent from the ECM to activate that ignition coil. So if we use other channels to read the trigger, you see that the trigger is going to be exactly according to the firing order. So if I change the timing right now, I can see this trigger much more clear like this. So as you see, the minimum voltage is almost zero, the maximum voltage is 5. So when that ignition coil is activated, we have just a signal like this sent to the ignition coil to activate it. So this confirms that the ECM is activating that ignition coil and the trigger signal is getting delivered to the ignition coil with no problem. But if you don't have anything over here, the problem could be from the trigger wire on the ECM or just the ECM itself. All right, guys, I'm gonna make another video for ignition coils with four wires as well to explain what is the fourth wire and how we can diagnose it. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video.